Hello and welcome to Business Today's weekly tech wrap, where we take you through the hottest headlines from the tech world this week. A case of Amazon Alexa listening in on a conversation and sending it to a random contact has come to light in Portland. According to reports, an Amazon Echo Dot smart speaker recorded a conversation between a wife and a husband and sent it to a contact in their contact list. Later on, it was found out to be a comedy of errors rather than AI playing an evil mastermind. According to reports, Amazon has clarified that the speaker woke up after picking up something similar to Alexa in the conversation and mistook a part of the conversation as a command to send a message. It even asked to whom and made a mistake again of picking a name from the conversation as one in the contact list. Amazon has clarified that this is a glitch particular to this certain unit. Samsung has been asked by a jury to pay $539 million to Apple for infringing iPhone design and utility patents. This brings a 7-year-old legal battle between the two tech giants to its final stages. Samsung was held liable of patent infringement in 2012, but a disagreement over the amount to be paid led to this retrial. Samsung has already paid $399 million to Apple in this matter. Apple is reimbursing 3,900 rupees to all its customers who paid for out-of-warranty battery replacement. This is an extension of Apple battery replacement program launched last year. The reimbursement will be paid on iPhone 6 and later models whose batteries were replaced between 1st of January 2017 and 28th of December 2017 at an Apple's authorized service station. Last year, Apple confessed to throttling performance on older iPhones on account of their weaker batteries. Xiaomi recently launched its online lending platform MiCredit in India. The lending platform lists financial loan providers and allows MIUI users to get easy personal loans from them. Xiaomi claims that a loan can be initiated within 10 minutes with simple KYC verification through its lending platform. As of now, MiCredit has listed only Credit B, which gives salary advances up to 1 lakh rupees to young professionals. OnePlus 6 went on sale in India earlier this week. The standard variants have been introduced in two configurations in Indian markets, one with 6GB of RAM and 64GB of internal storage priced at 34,999 rupees and another with 8GB of RAM and 128GB of internal storage priced at 39,999 rupees. The Avengers Infinity War Limited Edition OnePlus 6 is expected to hit the Indian market next week. The OnePlus 6 also received its first software update after going on sale. The software update brings security update for the month of May, brings the ability to hide the notch and some developments in the camera department. Qualcomm recently launched its Snapdragon 710 processor under the new Snapdragon 700 series of chipsets. It is expected to power premium mid-range Android smartphones. The Snapdragon 710 is based on 10 nanometer architecture and boasts 20% more performance than Snapdragon 660 while keeping power consumption in check. The Snapdragon 710 also boasts parts like X15 LTE modem and Spectre 250 image processor, which brings it closer to the flagship Snapdragon 845. The Snapdragon 710 also goes big on artificial intelligence and alternate reality. The first devices with Snapdragon 710 are expected to make an appearance in the second quarter this year. Realme 1, the first smartphone by Oppo's sub-brand Realme, went on sale in India earlier this week. The phone is available exclusively through Amazon and has been priced between 8,990 rupees and 13,990 rupees. Under the hood, the Realme 1 is powered by MediaTek Helio P60 processor and comes in three different configurations. The first with 3GB of RAM and 32GB of internal storage, and the another with 4GB of RAM and 64GB of internal storage. The top spec variant boasts 6GB of RAM and 128GB of internal storage. And that's all from us this week. If you like what we do here, please like, comment and share. And if you're watching this video on YouTube, do not forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon. Thank you.